Hello. And the next chapter is RLC network. So in this chapter we will study the circuits in which it will have two energy storage elements, capacitor and inductor. So in that there are two types, one is parallel RLC network, another one is series RLC network. So let us study first parallel RLC network. In that, without any forcing function or source free, we will consider. Later we will see driven parallel RLC network. After that, series source free and driven series RLC network. Okay. So this is parallel source free RLC network. We have a circuit here, resistor, inductor and capacitor, all are in parallel and with the voltage V across the capacitor and I flowing through the inductor. So we will assume a circuit with initial inductor current. Inductor is charged to I naught current and capacitor is charged to V naught voltage. So initially both are charged, capacitor as well as inductor, both are charged. And we do not have any other DC source here. It is a source free RLC network. First thing we have to do, we have to apply KCL at top node. So if we apply KCL at top node, current flowing through the resistor V by R plus current flowing through this inductor. How to write that? That is 1 by L 0 to T naught V of dt dash plus I of T naught, that is the initial current. So this one we have discussed while discussing the inductor. What is the current passing through the inductor? So this is the equation for that. And what is the current flowing through the capacitor? So current flowing through the capacitor is C dV by dt. So we have written KCL, all sum of leaving current equal to 0. Okay, that's the equation number 1. And we have assumed I of 0 plus is I naught and V of 0 plus is V naught. Now we will differentiate this above equation 1 with respect to time. So what happens? 1 by R, since we are differentiating with respect to time, this V is the variable, dV by dt plus 1 by L. And if you differentiate that, this will become V. So second term 1 by L into V. Third term is 0 because it is a initial current, it's a constant, it is 0. Fourth one is the, it's already we have one first order derivative. Again, if you take the differentiation, then it will be a second derivative. So C dV d square V by dt square equal to 0. So this equation is second order linear differential equation. We have constant coefficients. It's a second order linear differential equation. This you might have studied in the mathematics. Okay. Now we have to assume a solution for this. So we will follow the method like in the RL network or RC network. We assume the solution and we substitute that one and we will find the finally we will arrive at what will be the form of that assumed solution. Okay, so initially we will assume V of t equal to A into e power st, our standard this thing. This we assumed for RL and RC network also, since any signal can be represented using exponents or sum of exponents, we can safely assume this solution. Okay, once we assume this equation, then we will substitute this one in the equation 2. So what is that? 1 by R d by dt of V, first order differentiation of V. So that if you do 1 by R into A into S e power st plus 1 by L into V as it is. So A into e power st plus twice you have to differentiate here with respect to dt into C. So you will get C A S square e power st equal to 0. Now in this common term is A into e power st that you take outside. Inside you will get 1 by R into S plus 1 by L plus C S square equal to 0. To satisfy this equation, either A must be 0 or s must be minus infinity, but these two assumption will make our initial assumption, that is v of t equal to a into e power s t, will be 0. So that is a trivial solution, we will not assume that. The third one is the right one here, that is this term 1 by r into s plus 1 by l into plus c s square equal to 0, that will be 0. So this will be a quadratic equation in s, that will be, that is equal to 0, will be the solution for this expression, and we will call this expression as characteristic equation. And if you use quadratic equation and you solve this one, roots, it will have two roots, one is s1 and s2. S1 will be minus 1 by 2 rc plus under the square root 1 by 2 rc whole square minus 1 by lc. It is formula you apply here, so you will get one root s is here plus another root s minus you will get. So these are the two roots of this characteristic equation. So now what does this give? Our solution in the RL circuit or RC circuit, we had only one possible root, that was not a quadratic equation, we had a first order equation, but here we are getting a quadratic equation, so we will have two roots, hence we will have two solutions. So S1 and S2 can be used for S in the assumed solution. What is the assumed solution? Assumed solution is here V of t equal to A into e power ST. So in this case, one solution can be A e power S1 of t, another can be another constant A e power S2t. So that we will write here. So if you write that one, one solution can be V1 equal to A1 into e power S1t, another solution can be A2 into e power S2t. Both will satisfy because S1 and S2 both are the roots of the characteristic equation. We'll call them as 3 and 4. Since this is the solution, we can substitute that one in the main equation, in this second order differential equation, we can substitute that solution so that RHS equal to, RHS will be equal to LHS, or left hand side equal to right hand side. Okay, we will see that. So if you substitute that in the differential equation, so first solution is V1, so we will write V1 d square V1 by dt square plus 1 by r dV1 by dt plus 1 by L V1. Wherever we find V, we will substitute it by, we will replace it by V1 equal to 0. And similarly, the fourth equation will substitute in the same differential equation. That is also a solution. So then this will be C d square V2 divided by dt square plus 1 by r dv2 by dt plus 1 by l v2 equal to 0. Now v1 also can be a solution, v2 also can be a solution. Now if you add this equation, we will call it as a equation 5 and equation 6. These two, if you add, we will get one more equation, that is c into d square by dt square of v1 plus v2, 1 by r d by dt of v1 plus v2, and 1 by L into V1 plus V2 equal to 0. So that means if V1 is a solution, V2 is a solution, then V1 plus V2 is also a solution. So sum of solutions can also be a solution. Okay. So instead of assuming single exponent, we can assume a sum of two exponents here. Hence, general solution for the above equation, instead of simply assuming a into e power st, we can have a1 e power s1t plus a2 into e power s2t. So sum of solution, this is v1, this is v2. We have seen that v1 plus v2 is also a solution for the above differential equation. So we can add those two and we can have a general solution, general form like this, v of t equal to a1 e power s1t plus a2 into e power s2t. Where S1 and S2 are having dimension per second, because that will have any unit, sorry, S1T together will not have any unit. So S1 must be per second. So what is S1 and S2? This is the same, I am repeating that. S1 equal to minus 1 by 2 RC plus 1 by plus square root of 1 by 2 RC whole square minus LC. Here instead of plus, this will be minus. S2, you will get a minus sign here. Now instead of writing here complicated this expression, we will simplify it. We will replace it by terms. That is, let us define omega naught as 1 by root LC. And it will have the unit of frequency, and we will call it as a resonant frequency. You will understand the significance of this when we solve the problems. And second one is 1 by 2 RC, we will call alpha. It's Napier frequency. Okay, both will have the unit of frequency, and omega naught and alpha. Then our S1 will be minus alpha plus under the square root alpha square minus omega naught square. The same thing we are writing, instead of minus 1 by 2 RC, we are writing minus alpha. The same this thing we are writing, but instead of writing this big equation, we are simplifying it, and we are using the terms. Okay, so similarly S2 equal to minus alpha minus under the square root alpha square minus omega naught square. Now based on the alpha and omega naught value, our roots, this S1 and S2, can have different forms. If alpha is greater than, in this alpha is greater than omega naught, and both S1 and S2 are real, and we will call that response as overdamped response. Overdamped response. So the RLC network, in that alpha is greater than omega naught, the whatever response we get, that will have the shape of overdamped. What is this? Single RL and single RC network. But here in the RLC network, if S1 and S2 are real, the response will be overdamped. So we will see that later, how it is overdamped means, what will be the response. We will say that later. Just you want to mention that alpha is greater than omega naught, then S1, S2 are real. For the time being, we will just note this term overdamped, and what is the meaning of that, we will see later. Okay, if alpha is less than omega naught, if alpha is less than omega naught, then S1 and S2 are imaginary. Then the response we will call underdamped response. Response is called underdamped. And you can see here, when alpha is less than omega naught, then obviously you will get the negative root, you will get here. So you will, the term S1 and S2 will be imaginary. And there is one special case, when alpha is exactly equal to omega naught, then both S1 and S2 are real and concurrent. Both are having repeated roots. So S1 and S2 both will be minus alpha. So then the response we will call critically damped. Okay, critically damped response. So how it will be, we will see in the, when we solve the problem, we will understand what is this overdamped, underdamped, and critically damped.